Welcome to Six Sigma Online Certifications. We are on the topic Measure Phase, Measurement System Analysis Part 2. We'll talk about definitions of accuracy in this part. Bias. Bias is constant difference between measured values and true value across operating range. So let us try to understand. So for example, we have taken 6 samples across entire operating range, where the value of first sample is exactly 15, value of sample 2 is exactly 16, and these values are measured using a master instrument. So 15 to 20 is the operating range of the process in which we have taken 6 samples. Now each sample is measured 10 times. So we measured sample number 1 10 times, and when we used it using the instrument that we want to calibrate. So the average value of 10 readings is 16.1. When we measure the second sample, the average value of the 10 readings is 16.1. So we see the difference between the measured value and the true value is plus 1 constant, always plus 1. So when there is a constant difference between the mean of the measured values, these are the mean of the measured values, and respective true values, this is called as bias. This constant difference is called as bias. Now let us take the same 5 samples but another instrument. When we use another instrument and we measure the sample which has size 15 and we measured it 10 times, the average came out exactly 15. But when we measured the sample 2 which is actually having size 16, we got 16.1. When we measured 17 10 times and took the average, it came 17.2. What we are seeing is this bias is increasing as the value of the sample is increasing, which means when there is increasing or decreasing difference, this is difference between measured value and true value across operating range, we call it linearity. Linearity is changing bias across operating range. So we got stability. Stability is measuring bias over a period of time, and if this bias is in statistical control, we say measuring instrument is stable. We usually track it over a period of time, and one of the key objective of stability study is to set frequency of calibration. The other reason for doing the stability study is some critical measuring instruments which can get disturbed during running and therefore need to be tracked on regular basis. Now we'll discuss about the terms related to precision. Precision is also called as gauge, repeatability and reproducibility. What is repeatability and reproducibility? We will first understand and then we'll revisit this term. Repeatability means when you use same sample, you use same instrument and same standard operating procedure or method for measurement, and the same operator measures. That means nothing is changing. Everything of measurement system is same, and we still get variation in measurement. This is called as repeatability, gauge repeatability. On other hand, when my sample is same, now instrument and method is standardized, it is same, but different operators are measuring the same sample. When this variation is coming, this variation is called as reproducibility or gauge reproducibility. These two variations together is called as gauge repeatability and reproducibility, and often called as GRR. Why the reproducibility errors will come? If we don't train our operators in standard methods, the method from operator to operator changes, and it is often resulting into reproducibility error, which is called as operator variation. But when there are some physical differences in between the operators, because of which the values measured by one operator and the other operator for the same value is different, then we call it operator part interaction. Let us understand what is physical significance of GRR. For example, we want to measure using a measurement system, present measurement system, we want to measure a value somewhere here, which is very close to specification. When we want to measure something here or we want to measure something away from the specification. When we measure something away from the specification, we cannot go wrong in our measurement, because if it is bad, it is so bad that it will be distinguished as bad. If it is good, that means towards the center, it is so good that it cannot be distinguished as bad. But when we are taking such decision very close to the specifications, for example, if my part is here, it is likely a good part may get rejected as bad. Or if it is bad, it is possible that a bad part gets accepted as a good part and goes to the customer and comes in the form of customer complaints. So this region close to specification is called as wrong decision region, and the one which is away from the specification is called as correct decision region. So what is percentage GRR? Chances of wrong decision, that means this length, this is measurement system variation, and total decision taken for goodness, that means between specifications, this is goodness decisions. So if we want to say variation in measurement to tolerance is USL minus LSL. So what is variation in measurement? It is 6 times measurement system, whereas what is the difference, what is tolerance? USL minus LSL. This value is called as percentage GRR. And if this value is less than 10%, we say our measurement system is excellent. If it is between 10 to 30%, we say acceptable. Beyond 30, it has to be rejected. Measurement system has to be improved. Thank you very much for testing your knowledge on this video or for Six Sigma certification. Please visit leandigit.com. For getting more updates about Six Sigma online certifications, please subscribe this channel. Thank you.